From the world of business this week, reports indicate there was an increase in coffee and gold exports, which I believe is very good news for people that are dealing in those particular goods here in Uganda. Welcome to the Business Roundup for this week. And here to discuss some other stories in addition to this one is John Ricks Kayizi, who is a business journalist with The New Vision. Thank you so much for joining us. Let's dive in. So John, let's start with the President's commissioning of factories at the Sino Industrial Park in Mbale. How do you think this is going to impact the area? Plus, how can people living in that particular part of the country get to benefit from this new development?
Yesterday, we saw a significant event on Uganda's economic calendar. That was commissioning of 15 companies in the Sino Uganda industrial area, industrial park in Mbale. And that signifies a change when it comes to Uganda's economic development trajectory, especially the industrialization agenda. And some of the particular activities that are taking place in the park include production of textiles, which are very, very important when it comes to industrialization. For many years, Uganda has been producing cotton, but you have been exporting it raw. So the president is putting his foot down and saying we have to take a significant step in harnessing this market, very big market for textiles, which has been taken over by important fabrics, which preferred by the Ugandans, but at the end of the day, they don't last and they are not durable. Yes. People in that area can actually benefit a great deal out of these economic activities, because the president pointed out that around 2,000 youths have earned jobs in these new factories. And it means that people are getting an income. People are getting an income, and they are actually changing the livelihood of many people, many homes. They are now have some capacity to earn monthly salary and then be able to cater for their needs.
So let's now move on to the Uganda Revenue Authority, who released their report for the year 2022-2023. What's in this report and what does this mean for people that are responsible for paying taxes in this country, especially at a time where we have like the World Bank saying they are holding back their aid to a country like Uganda?
Yeah, the URA report is actually giving us a very good picture concerning the expansion of the domestic tax base. Yeah. Yeah, which in a view brings in the issue of mopping up capital to fund the industrialization agenda, because we can no longer depend on partners. The World Bank decision to halt rallies of development finances actually opened our eyes to the fact that we can no longer depend on foreign capital for development, and URA is actually the main vehicle which can drive that agenda, because people have to get into a culture of paying taxes for development of infrastructure, development of hospitals and all the other things. Yeah.
And finally, John, there is new management at the NSSF, as well as they're coming around with a new strategy. Please discuss this in detail and let us know how it is going to impact the savings for the citizens of Uganda.
Yeah, finally we have a new team at NSSF, and I believe this is going to stabilize the fund, because first of all, the NSSF is the biggest fund. It's bigger than any commercial bank around. They have around shillings 8.4 trillion on their account, in their coffers. So they are big, and the government needed to come out and pronounce itself on the management of the fund.
All right, thank you so much for making time to talk to us about some of these stories from the world of business. And to you, we appreciate your time every time you tune in to watch the Business Roundup here on the news. I am Viola Xasia. Until next week, good night.